Hi, I'm Carly McAvoy. I'm talking about slope, finding the slope of a line when it's in an alternate form, not in slope-intercept form. When a line is in a different form, you can rearrange it into slope-intercept form. Remember, slope-intercept form is y equals mx plus b. So let's say we have this line, 3x plus y equals 4, and we want to change it. We can't say the slope is 3 because it's not in the correct format. So what we want to do is move the 3x to the other side, and we're going to do that by subtracting 3x from both sides. And when I write the answer, I want to write it so that the y is by itself, followed by the x term, followed by b. So I have y equals negative 3x plus 4. Now when it's in this format, I can clearly see the slope is negative 3. Well, this one's a little more complicated because I have a coefficient next to the y that's not 1. This one had a coefficient of y, so it's going to take us a couple of steps. But first, I do want to get that y by itself, so I want to move the 4x to the other side, and I'm going to add 4x to both sides to do that. And then I'm going to write it in that format where I have the y on one side, the x on the opposite side, and then following the equal sign, and then that number at the end. This coefficient of 2 we have to get rid of. So I'm going to divide everything by 2. I have 3 terms, so I have to divide all of them by 2. And when I do, I get these 2 cancel, getting y. 4 over 2 is 2, and I have 5 halves. So my slope right here is positive 2. This negative 3 would represent a line that falls from left to right. This positive 2 would represent a line that rises from left to right. And the other thing that you're asked to do on your homework is what if you had an equation in one of these two formats, x equals negative 4 or y equals negative 3. The easiest way for me to show you how to find the slope of those lines is to actually graph them. And so I did this earlier and made a pretty significant mistake, so I'm kind of repeating the video. If you have x equals negative 4, remember that means that every single x that you choose has to be negative 4 because it's telling you x has to be negative 4. So then you say, well, what if y is 0, 1, or negative 2? So we have negative 4, 0, negative 4, 1, negative 4, negative 2. We have all these points that line up to make a vertical line. If you look from one point to the other, the rise, 1, 2, 3, is 3. But the run, well, there's no run. We're not going left or right. It's just 0. And when you divide by 0, your slope is undefined. So if you're given an equation where x equals a number, you're always going to have undefined slope. But on the other hand, if y was negative 3, then y is negative 3. And x could be anything you want it to be. I chose 0, 1, negative 2. So I say if x is 0, y is negative 3. If x is 1, y is negative 3. If x is negative 2, y is negative 3. And I end up with a horizontal line at negative 3. In this case, if you look from point to point, or whichever of these points we look at, we can see that there's no rise. The rise is 0. And then from one point to the next, we could have 2 or 3, doesn't matter, because 0 divided by anything is still 0. So when you have y equals some number, your slope is always going to be 0. When you have x equals some number, your slope is going to be undefined. Those are two different things. All right. What is the a and b? This is from another video that I was talking about. A, remember, is the x-intercept where it crosses the x-axis. And B is the y-intercept where it crosses the y-axis. You can see that vertical lines are never going to cross the y-axis, and horizontal lines are never going to cross the x-axis. All right, have a fantastic day, and I'll see you next time.